kind of impact will Audrey Faber have for the Blue Jays today? That is one of the questions for this Creighton team. Lilborn misses her first shot. Out to Blockton, player of the year, knocks it down.
And I expect Jim Flannery to play the
final against St. John's.
And we expect to see her quite a bit today because of her defensive prowess. Moves her feet well for a freshman, works really hard to get stops.
Into the corner for Blockton, and she has hit her first two shots. Three shooting. Take away from Danielle King, the Chicago native. She gets it out to Davenport for the easy two. Sailing in for two, body bucket and one, Imani Wilborn.
Are you kidding me? Not only the spin move, but check out the air time here on the finish. That was almost a double pump in midair. Takes the contact. She's got three defenders trying to stop this game.
Elger right about at her average right now. Wilborn from the baseline.
I don't think Imani Wilborn has ever seen an easy basket.
Wilborn to take that. Into the corner for King. Corner pocket.
The shots that the game went on. Now, she hasn't performed well against St. John's historically, and sometimes it's matchup driven, but she found her stroke before it was all said and done. And here's the Big East Player of the Year.
Kick out to Blockton for three. That one are out of the round and through. Alice, as a pro, how would you use her? There she is again. Hold that thought. Marquette's on the transition to Heidemann. Blocking foul. Body bucket and one. Blockton with the assist.
Elger tries to rotate back. I think what cost her on that was that she started to move back before there was any contact made. Marquette's not running away with this game either, so they're hitting enough shots the right time to stay in this.
It's an energy battle. Coach Keeger telling us that when you face Creighton, it's always going to be an energy battle. Blockton for three. Imani Wilborn spins and fires.
Money, Monty is what we're gonna start calling Wilborn.
The in-game reset focus adjustments. This team, now a team of juniors, gotta get used to. How about that? Hit the reset button. Kaboom. There you see no timeouts left for Creighton. Marquette still has one left, but Creighton does have some fouls to give. And they turn it over. Guess who? Blockton with the cherry on top for Marquette. Marquette gets it done. Golden Eagles have a chance to defend their tournament title.